Hey guys, I'm Gebhardt and welcome to Empower Church online channel. And today I want to speak to you about the covenant of righteousness. That's right, I want to speak to you about the covenant of righteousness. And we're going to go to the Bible in Genesis chapter number 15 and verse number 4. The Bible says this, "And behold the word of the Lord." Now this is very important. "The word of the Lord came to him saying, this one shall not be your head, but the one that will come from your own body shall be your head." I want you just to note there before I read on that the word of the Lord came to him. You'll see and you'll find in the Bible that God does not touch many things. In actual fact, God speaks to most things. In other words, he spoke to the earth and the earth came into existence. In other words, he said, "Light be," and light was. But secondly, and this is very important, when God speaks, we have to understand in his word is creative power. In other words, when God speaks something, when God declares something, he needs a man just to agree with him, and then that shall come to pass. The word of the Lord cannot fail. But listen, let's go on. "This one shall not be your heir, but one who will come from your own body shall be your heir." Verse 5. "Then he brought him outside and said, look now toward the heaven and count the stars, if you are able to number them. And he said to him, so shall your descendants be." Powerful. Verse number 6. "And he believed in the Lord, and he accounted it to him for righteousness." I love that scripture. Let me read it again. "And he believed in the Lord, and he accounted it to him for righteousness." Now, this word accounted here is the word credited. In other words, if you can liken it to something, you can liken it to this. It's like receiving an SMS. In other words, if you have a mobile phone in your hand and suddenly you receive an SMS with a credit or a bank SMS that says a certain amount came into your account, this is the word credit. In other words, the day you believe in the Lord, your account gets credited for righteousness. Now it goes deeper than that. The word righteousness means that God sees you the way he sees Jesus. That's right. God sees you the way he sees Jesus. And later on in scripture, if you study Romans chapter number 4 from verse 20 onwards, you'll find that the Bible says this, that God counted Abram as if all the former things, he did not do it. I'll say it again. God counted Abram as if all the things that he did previously did not matter. It's almost like God literally just wiped that away. Now, here's an important truth for us. The Bible says in Romans chapter number 8, verse number 37 to 39, Paul the Apostle says this, "Nor height, nor depth, nor angel, nor demon, nor present, nor future." Please see something here, and here's a very important truth. God, through the Apostle Paul, leaves out the past. Why does he leave out the past? Good question, and here's the answer. Why does God leave out the past? Because each time you and I examine ourselves outside of the blood and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, we open ourselves up to a spirit of deception, and we open ourselves up to a lie. I'll say that again. Each time you examine yourself outside the blood of Jesus and outside the grace of Jesus Christ, you are opening up yourself to deception, because the past has been paid for. It has been bought by the blood of Jesus Christ. You and I have no right to examine our past outside the blood and the grace and the finished work of the Lord Jesus. In doing so, we are visiting a deception and we are visiting a lie. But when you have covenant with God, or when God cuts covenant with you, there's three things that happen. Number one, he changes your name. That's right, he shifts your name. You see it with Abram. Abram becomes Abraham, for an example. So each time God cuts covenant, he changes a name. You see Jacob, he becomes Israel. You see Simon, he becomes Peter. When there's a name change, there is a covenant that is being made. So the first thing that God does when he cuts covenant, he changes your name. Now, why is a name change important for you? Because a name change means that your destiny has just been altered, or your destiny has just shifted. For example, if somebody has my name, it means they carry my nature. It means that they are a co-heir. It means they have a right. It means they have an inheritance. There's so many things in a name. For an example, let me go deeper. That's why the Bible says it is in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, when you say in the name, that name has got so many things. His name is Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, Mighty God, Counselor. There is so many things, as the Bible says in Isaiah chapter number 9, that is in His name. You have to understand, when you say a name, or when you say in His name, we are speaking about everything that is locked up in that name. But when you've got covenant, or when the Lord cuts covenant with you, there's three things that happen. First and foremost, a name changes or happens. The second thing that happens when you cut covenant with God, second thing that happens, very, very important, is there's an exchange of weaponry. I'll say that again. There's an exchange of weaponry. We receive the weapons of God. That's why the Bible says, yeah, and it's all through the covenant of righteousness. You receive the weapons of God. What is the weapons of God? Well, there are multiple weapons. I'll just name a few. One of the weapons that you've received is praise. Another weapon you've received is worship. Another weapon you've received is the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the shield of faith, the lance of prayer and supplication, the sword of the Spirit, the belt of truth, the shoes of peace. You have been armed to the gills. You have been armed well by the Lord. But more importantly, if you study the scripture, it means that you've been shielded by God. In actual fact, God says it to Abram. He says, Abram, I will shield you. So again, there's three things that happens when you cut covenant of God. The first one is very, very simple, is you and I receive a new name. The second thing that happens, you and I receive a new weaponry. And then the third thing, and this is very, very powerful, and I want you to understand this, and I want you to see this, and I want you to behold the goodness of God, because God is good, and His mercy endures forever. I'll say it again. God is good, and His mercy endures forever. When you cut covenant, and somebody has sinned in that covenant, the firstborn must give his life. I'll say it again. When you cut covenant, and somebody sins in that covenant, the firstborn must give his life. That's why Jesus Christ died on the cross. He was the firstborn. It's not the first race. He was the firstborn from the dead. So you and I have a covenant of God. And our covenant of God is the covenant of righteousness. Now, the covenant of righteousness is very powerful, because it means He became that you can become. He became my sin so that I can become His righteousness. He became guilty so that I can be innocent. Righteousness is an equalizer among all men. I'll say again. Righteousness is an equalizer among all men. It doesn't matter your status. It doesn't matter your background. It doesn't matter your bank account. It doesn't matter your even how big or small you think you are in your own eyes. We all need the righteousness that is imputed to us through Christ Jesus. All of us need our accounts to be accredited with righteousness based on the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is imperative for you to understand. In our next segment, I want to go a little bit deeper and explain righteousness for you more. Because once we understand righteousness, our minds needs to shift. That it is no longer based on performance, that we make it into the kingdom. Listen, God is not looking for performers. God is looking for sons on altars. That is why His Son modeled a way for us. Jesus died on an altar. The Lord's mantle looks like a cross. You and I cannot have a different way, methodology, or any other way. There is just an altar, and you and I will die daily as we preach this gospel. And the Bible says we must be unashamed of the gospel, because this gospel has the ability to change us and shift us into righteousness. But stay with me. Let's go to the second segment, and let me teach you on the beautiful premise and the covenant of righteousness. Lastly, I want to ask you, if you have not yet done so, please subscribe, hit that bell button, and become part of Empower Church Online eFamily.